Welcome back to Brooklyn Test Kitchen. I'm your host, Robert, and today we're going to try something really exciting. We're going to play around with the new craze hitting the borough, which is the Vitamix. We're going to try an apple acorn squash soup. It's really easy to make. It takes about 20 minutes. We have fresh ingredients. We're going to do it right here in our nice little apartment kitchen. All right, let's get started. So we're going to need one acorn squash. We're going to need one very large apple. We're only going to use about a half of it. We're going to need about a half a clove of garlic. You can adjust it based on your taste. You're going to need some thyme, about a quarter teaspoon. You're going to need 2 cups of broth. I went with the turkey broth, but you could use vegetable or you could use chicken, but I'm going to go with turkey because it's the season. And you're going to need about a tablespoon of olive oil. First thing we're going to do is we're going to take this squash. We only need about 3 cups of it. But we're going to take this squash and we're going to cut it open. And we are going to de-seed and peel. And that's basically the game. Finish peeling the skin off of our acorn squash. We've had our pot of water steaming over here. We're going to go ahead and add the acorn squash on in. There we go. And we're going to let this steam for a little bit. While it's steaming, we're gonna cut up our onion and our garlic, and we're gonna get that sauteing next. So don't stress too much about how you're preparing the vegetables. That's one of the really nice things about the Vitamix, is you don't have to worry about the presentation that you're giving this very, very powerful machine. And before I do the garlic, I'm gonna get our saute pan going with a little olive oil. All right, so once our onions and our garlic are nice and chopped up, we can kind of put them together, and they're gonna go into the saute together. Oh yeah. All right, so we'll let these guys go for just a little bit while the squash is steaming, and then we're gonna look at the apples. Find the biggest apple in your neighborhood, all right? Nice big apple. We're gonna quarter it. We're only gonna use one half of the apple. I'm gonna leave the skin on. I like the skin. Kind of cut out some of those seeds. Just kind of give it a little boop. Nothing like a fresh apple in Brooklyn. We're gonna take our two biggest quarters and we're gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna give them one more little chop. Gonna chop, and we're gonna go ahead and start these off down at the bottom of the Vitamix. Just let those get in there first. Everything else is softer and it'll be at the top, so the Vitamix can really get started on the apple, and it'll bring everything down that we've been softening up over here on the stove. All right, so we're looking pretty good here. We got the squash just about ready here, down in the steamer, and our delicious smelling garlic and onions. Oh yeah. Looking pretty good here, just about ready. Start that caramelization process. It's starting to get very exciting. I'm gonna try out in our test kitchen today with some mesquite smoked Pacific sea salt. You can find it at most places. And it should just give us just a little more flavor. You don't have to do it. I'm just gonna try it out and see what happens, all right? So let's go ahead and get this garlic and onion. Oh yeah. Onions and garlic in here before it goes into the Vitamix. Look at that, nice golden brown. We're gonna add to it our delicious steamed squash. See that steam rolling off? Very nice. All right. Let's bring our Vitamix over. The first thing we're gonna do before we drop anything in is we're gonna just put a little broth at the bottom just to get it below those apples. And then we're gonna dump everything in, guys. We're going to just finish it off with the thyme, the rest of our broth, and like I said, just a dash of salt. Just a dash. All right, so once you have everything in your Vitamix, we're gonna start at variable 1. And then we're basically gonna slowly work up to 10, and then once you get up to 10, we're gonna crank it on high for about 5 to 6 minutes. So this is the real, this is where the real action goes down. Oh yeah. Elements down into its blender apparatus and then shooting it back up through a vortex that's blending all the flavors elements together into one. Just a couple seconds away and we're going to be sitting down for a delicious soup any second. Woo! I think we're ready, guys. Let's see how we did. Woo! Oh yeah. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you. Oh yeah, the turkey broth is very subtle, but it's definitely there. The most incredible thing about the Vitamix is its versatility. We can go everything from this incredible, healthy, hearty meal, and then we can make a smoothie, frappuccino, whatever you want later. And now we're just gonna pour a little into a bowl. I like to add a little dollop of some Greek yogurt. You could use sour cream if you like, just a little dollop. And then we'll give it a little parsley. And we have a delicious meal right from Vitamix. All right, and that's our Brooklyn Test Kitchen with Vitamix. We'll be back soon. I hope you guys enjoy your regular programming. And I'll see you guys soon. Forget about it.
Hey, check out these records I just got.
No, man, I gotta run. Thank you.
All right, bye, Martha.
Sick. Hey, girl.
Oh, hey, Sue. How are you?
Good, how are you?
what... Oh, look at that guy over there. He could be a firefighter. Maybe off duty.
Easy, Barbarella, but definitely. Oh, geez, I have to go. I'm sorry. I'll see you later.
How do you get the hooks out?
You're beautiful.
How do you get the hooks out?
Hooks?
The fish hooks!
We use nets.
Shit!
I know a lot about fish.
I get off at 6. I'd love to talk to you about it.
Thanks, bro.
What the hell was that?
Like they sing it here.
Yeah, hey, your guy didn't know jack about fishing. Yeah, I thought it was some terrorist organization or something trying to find dynamite. Yeah, okay. Now I'm back to square one. No, man, I'm not interested. Thanks.
The bees envy me.